StarCraft II dominated Blizzard's worldwide invitational, while the best Warcraft 3 players ever assembled fought for the championship. Before we head into the action, I have a story which some of you might have heard, but I'll tell nonetheless. Todd, of course, played in the Worldwide Invitational, and if you look at the picture, there he is up on stage in his fancy soundproof box. You might also notice that the door is open. Wherein lies the story? When Todd first entered the box, he said, and I quote, "Oh my God," unquote. In an interview, he commented that, quote, "It's a secret for nobody that I play bad when it's hot," unquote. When the tournament officials told Todd that the door must be closed, he explained, and again, I'm quoting directly from Todd, that, quote, "non-Asian people perspire more than Asian people," unquote. After Todd refused to play with the door closed, the tournament officials decided to let it stay open. If only every tournament could have excitement like this. This tournament did have more than its fair share of talent. Let's run through the list of players. Todd, who placed second at World Cyber Games 2006, Remind, who won BattleNet Season 4, Fav won Electronic Sports World Cup, Grubby has won World Cyber Games and Electronic Sports World Cup, Sky, of course, won World Cyber Games 2005 and 2006, Sweet won the first Blizzard Worldwide Invitational, and finally Spirit Moon needs no introduction. The only outlier was Nilknarf, whose greatest accomplishment is qualifying for the World Cyber Games. Let's move on to quarterfinal action with Fav playing against Grubby.
The first game started uneventfully, with both players doing some minor harassment and creeping. Early on, the game was about proper positioning. Grubby gets in close to Fav and forces a TP. Pushing his advantage, Grubby forces another TP and builds an expansion. Fav counters with destroyers and Grubby is forced to use a speed scroll. At the same time, Fav uses three ghouls to take the expo down, evening up the game. Fav attempts to push into Grubby's base. While he does take out a few burrows, they still remain extremely evenly matched. When Grubby attempted to expo again, Fav goes in to take it down, but forgets a town portal. The one cardinal sin of playing undead is forgetting your town portal. Because of it, he loses his death knight. Fav makes yet another burrow raid while Grubby has difficulty fighting it off until he finally forces a town portal. The game boiled down to whether or not Grubby had enough Batriders to take out Fav's destroyers. The first test comes over Grubby's expo. Fav wins the battle and takes out the expansion. Without the expo, Fav's Frostworms overpower Grubby, and Fav wins the game. The game starts off with some basic harassment, but quickly picks up when Fav uses a sapper to take out a burrow. Grubby takes it one step further, taking out three acolytes and two ziggurats with his sapper. Grubby's harassment gave him the edge, forcing Fav to TP further back into his base. Their armies looked equal going into the final battle, but Grubby's heroes and expansion gave him the advantage. Fav's Death Knight proved to be no match for the Blade Master. After an exciting first two games, the final game simply comes down to a stupid mistake by Grubby. He sits at 50 food for far too long and was forced to fight Fav down 20 food. Not even Grubby can come back from that. Fav wins in three games.
Next up is some more quarterfinal action with Remind against Todd.
Game 1 starts with Todd fast expoing while Remind creeps his Dark Ranger to level 3. The harassment starts 5 minutes into the game and hardly ever lets up. Even Todd's second hero only gives him a short break before Remind continues the assault. Finally, with the help of some mercenary, Todd forces Remind out of his base. But Todd's economy has been crippled by the countless peasants he lost defending his expansion. When Remind returns, Todd's mercenary army is absolutely no match for Remind's dryads and bears. Remind has taken an intense spring to win. Game 2 also started with a fast expo by Todd, but this time he gets a surround on the Demon Hunter. Remind is quick to use his Cloak of Shadows, but Todd counters with a reveal from the Goblin Shop. With the early advantage, Todd easily puts up his expansion. Remind attacks so fast that he was unable to put up any pressure on Todd. Without any attacks, Todd quickly builds up his army. Remind's first legitimate attack comes 9 minutes into the game, when he used a couple of Ancients of War to push into Todd's expansion. Todd is still making footmen, but Remind's army doesn't counter footmen, so Todd still has a huge advantage.
While reminding switches from Druze of the talent to bear, Todd quickly pulls out an 80-food Night Elf demolishing army. That is no less than twice the amount of food of Remind's army. The final battle is less of a battle and more of a slaughter. Todd only loses 2 footmen.
Job done.
After 2 crazy close first games, the third game was a huge letdown. Todd and Remind spawned close positions on Turtle Rock, and once Todd recognizes the situation, he sends his militia over and takes down Remind's altar. That altar was late because Remind was going for a neutral hero. After that, there wasn't really anything Remind could do to come back. Remind should have been angry about not having this opportunity to play Todd on a real Game 3. Let's move on to the semifinals with Fav against Sky.
We didn't show you Sky against Sweet, because those games were just like these. Very, very long. Sky starts off with a fast expo and a paladin. Fav learned quickly that the paladin wants to harass his acolytes. A full wall of ziggurats stops that plan. Also, to counter the paladin, he goes Dreadlord with Sleep, which renders the paladin somewhat useless. To take it one step further, Fav gets a Dark Ranger and Silence. Now Fav must attempt the impossible, to counter towers with Siege. Despite his superior army, Sky can run in, kill the siege, and retreat. Finally, Fav's tri-hero catches Sky without a town portal, and the paladin falls. Without the paladin, Fav has a full 30 seconds before the griffins show up to counter his siege. As Fav expos, we witness the full bullshit that is the paladin strategy. Even with us around, Fav is still unable to kill the paladin. Fav makes one mistake. He never realizes that Sky is actually amassing an army behind his harassment. Fav won't make the same mistake twice. Game 2 started off as a disaster for Sky and didn't get much better. It starts off with Sky not seeing a lightning shield while creeping as he lost 4 peasants and a footman. The extra slowdown allows Fav's level 3 pinned and 10 ghouls to stop Sky's expansion. Because